Hey everybody, welcome to Art City Comics. I'm Argiana AF. So I just found this article on The Mary Sue. Like, what a great website this is. My goodness, way to try to take back the name. You know, I really think that women need to really gain that power back. So I found this really interesting article. So the headline reads, "Even Captain Marvel's deleted scenes aren't safe from men's bad opinions." Oh my God, what isn't these days though, right? So it's written by this Rachel person, and she's just lovely. She writes, "In case you thought we were finally past the point of having to deal with men's overzealous scrutiny of Captain Marvel, the consensus is now that she's unlikable and a, quote, villain, all because of a recently released deleted scene." That's kind of interesting because if you read the comic book, she kind of actually is a villain. It's kind of weird, actually. There was this time where she held this kid, she held this girl and a couple other people hostage for crimes that they didn't commit yet. Like, Minority Report, right? And then, like, later on, she had Miles Morales imprisoned, who he's like a little kid. He's like totally a minor, and Iron Man was trying to step up and save him, and she totally killed Iron Man. I mean, not really, because it's comic book, so he was in a coma for a while, but yeah, totally not a villain though, right? Anyway, so in this scene, Carol is approached by a gross man, aren't they all? And when he tries to come onto her, she uses her power to take his bike and leaves. Because she almost, quote, maims him, people, primarily men, are angry. What is this? Which just shows you, guys have never been cornered by a man with no feasible means of escape. What? Are you saying that, like, a man has never been beaten up or taken advantage of by another man? Like, did you ever see that show Oz? Oh my God, like, it made Orange is the New Black look like the Rugrats. Like, my goodness. Moving on, though. She writes, "As a woman in the 21st century, I'd give nothing more than to have powers that would let me escape from a man in a way that Captain Marvel does in this scene. I'd love to be able to scare someone out of touching me against my will. But I guess then that would make me a villain, right?" Well, sweetheart, it really kind of depends on how you go about doing that. Like, you can't just be beating up guys because you feel they look at you wrong. That is kind of villainous. And then she embeds some tweets by some just toxic men here. It's just awful. She says, "I feel like..." Now, wait a minute, sweetheart. This is supposed to be like a news article, and you've turned it into a blog because you've totally interjected yourself all over it. Like, journalism, you're supposed to remove yourself from the story, you know, to give like an unbiased opinion. So, I don't know. We'll skip past there to where she stops talking about herself. She says, "Here's the thing about Carol Danvers. She's strong, she's confident, and she doesn't take nonsense from anyone. You know who else is that way? Half the Avengers. But because she's a woman, some people see it as a major problem. I guess she has to be in the corner crying for half of her movie in order for her to be a completely well-rounded character in their eyes. What's fun about the Avengers is that everyone is overconfident, almost to a fault. Carol just happens to be coming in when all the other Avengers have realized in universe-having fashion what their overconfidence got them. It's called hubris, honey. Pick up a thesaurus and you might learn some more words. It's got all kinds of fun words for other words in it. It's great. You should check it out." No, I don't think she has to be crying for half of her movie, but character development is always a good thing, and having flaws makes you more relatable, you know? Like, if she grew up and she was poor, you're going to relate with a lot of poor people, you know? It's weird. So she continues, "But still, they're all that way. Stephen Strange and Tony Stark are literally two of the most overconfident men to ever walk the planet. But people praise them. So what's the deal? Well, they each also have a lot of flaws. I mean, Tony is like an alcoholic. He's like off and on the wagon like every year. It's just kind of like you can almost set your watch to it at this point. It gives him more development. It gives more interesting like story arcs and stuff. So she asks, is it just because Carol is a woman or because her, quote, overconfidence, hubris, sweetie, hubris, is warranted? Whatever the case is, all the tweets bashing her for her qualities than other Avengers have shows that their hatred of her doesn't come from a place of genuine criticism, but from a place of sexism. Sweetheart, you are spreading your own sexism all over this article. I mean, all over it. It's really, it's bad, sweetie. You need to take yourself away a little bit here. So she finishes by saying, the problem isn't that she's cocky or overconfident. It's that she is a woman with these attributes. And as much as these men don't want to realize that they're being sexist, they are. Sweetie. Conjecture. You're reaching. Hating a female character is totally okay. Hating her for the same characteristics you love in Tony Stark and Stephen Strange? Definitely showing your true colors. That's not the point. Like I said in the beginning, you know, she's done a lot of really awful things in the name of heroics. Now, I know Iron Man and Stephen Strange, Doctor Strange, I don't know why she doesn't want to call him Doctor. They have their faults, like a lot of them. And I know they've done some pretty awful things in order to, you know, save the world. But I don't think any of it's quite as bad as, you know, imprisoning underage teenagers for crimes they haven't committed. That's pretty awful. Like, come on, yo. So I wouldn't go back up here. Let's see. She had this tweet by a congressman. So I wanted to pull that up just to see, like what's, like, some congressman had to talk about it. Well, I don't know if we're going to watch this. I don't know. I haven't watched it yet, so we'll hold on a second here. This is Joey Salads. He's a YouTuber. Apparently, he's running for office. I don't know if I would vote for a YouTuber or not. You know, like, things are kind of bad as it is without that kind of shit. But, okay, so I guess it's going to play anyway, so let's look at it, shall we? This is just bad. Oh, my God, the smile comment. She didn't even ask for his help. This is just badly written. Oh, well, he smiled. Who's Veers? Oh, he almost pulled her over there. Oh.
Here's a proposition for you. You're going to give me your jacket, your helmet, and your motorcycle, and in return, I'm going to you keep your hand.
Oh, how kind of you, doll. What?
What, a smile?
Oh, because he talked to her? My goodness. Ooh, look at that glare. What the? Did she just steal from that lady's shop? Oh, my God. She stole the motorcycle and that dress. Oh, and she almost wrecked her. Oh, she almost wrecked the damn thing. She shouldn't even be on the road. My goodness. Oh, look at all these. Oh, almost 34,000 likes. Look at that. So much toxic masculinity. It's disgusting. Oh, that's probably fake. I'm sure it's not a real person. Oh, another fake female. Oh, gee, mini Christmas. They're all fake females. Oh, there's a toxic male. Oh, another fakey. Doesn't even have a real name. Another fake account. Look at all these fake accounts. I don't even know what that's about. Another fake one. Oh, just, yeah. I guarantee that's a toxic male. Guarantee it. Oh, it does. That makes me sick. That makes me sick. No, I still think that she's a villain. Like, that wasn't really very cool, what she did to that dude. Like, I know he's kind of creepy, but, you know, she's kind of got, like, godlike powers. And it's a little of an overreaction, I'd say. I think the whole scene was just really badly written. I see why it was deleted. That was definitely not a very good scene to have in, I think, any kind of movie. That was just bad. Anywho, I'll see you guys next time. I need to figure out what is going on with my voice. It has just been all over the place lately. And now I've got this female accent after reading this Mary Sue article. I think it turned me into a feminist. I gotta go, guys. Subscribe.